Greetings, family of God. It is indeed an honor and a privilege to have you connect with us this morning. Let us take a few moments to meditate on God's word. And my scripture reading is taken from Isaiah 54 verse 10. I pray that this word will enter your heart and allow faith to arise. For the mountains shall depart and the hills be removed, but my kindness shall not depart from you, nor shall my covenant of peace be removed, says the Lord, who has mercy on you. O you afflicted one, tossed with tempest and not comforted, behold, I will lay your stones with colorful gems and lay your foundations with sapphires. I will make your pinnacles of rubies, your gates of crystal, and all your walls of precious stones. All your children shall be taught by the Lord. You shall be far from oppression, for you shall not fear, and from terror, for it shall not come near you. Indeed, they shall surely assemble, but not because of me. Whoever assembles against you shall fall for your sake. Behold, I have created the blacksmith who blows the coals in the fire, who brings forth an instrument for his work, and I have created the spoiler to destroy. And no weapon formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue which rises against you in judgment you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is from me, says the Lord. Amen. Just going to open in prayer at this time. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, dear God, that it is indeed a privilege to be called your children, O God. Father, we thank you for this day, for this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it, Father. We thank you, O God, for your love, your mercy. We thank you for your hands of protection and for provision, O God. Thank you, O God, that we have so much that we are thankful for, O God. Father, you are our everything, and we give you praise, and we give you glory, and we give you honor, O God. Father, we want to say you are Christ, the Creator, our Redeemer, our Sustainer, O God. Christ, the Ruler, O God. Father, we thank you because you are our way maker and our promise keeper, Father. Lord, we just bless your wonderful name. Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you, O God, for our service. Lord, bless our worshiper, Father. May we surrender our all to you, O God. Bless our worship team, O God. Father, we thank you for them and for their lives, O God. Father, we pray very especially for the word, O God. I pray, O God, that it'll bless our hearts, Father. And, O God, we know, Father, that when we hear your word, Father, that you will feed our faith, O God, through your word, O God, and that faith will increase in our lives, Father. For without faith, O God, is impossible to please you. So bless us, O God. Holy Spirit, lead, guide, and direct us, Father, in everything that we do and say, and bless our service. Bless us, O God, we pray, as we further continue and we praise and worship you in your presence, O God. Father, we love you. We honor you and we worship you, and we ask all of this in no other name but the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Good morning, family and friends. It is so good to get together just to praise that wonderful name of Jesus. It is vital that we do not neglect the gathering of the saints, and we declare that soon we will be found in the house of the Lord. It is incredible that we get to celebrate women in the month of August, especially in South Africa. We are daughters of the King, and we are not moved by the world. Instead, we are moved by God's word. And our delight is found in the book of the law, which we meditate day and night. And God's promise is that heaven and earth will pass away, but his word will not pass away. So no matter what troubles we are facing, and we know that Satan will leave no stone unturned when it comes to the church, But God's word is specific. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. So even COVID-19, whatever fears and anxieties, will have to bow at the foot of the cross. And we know that God's promises, He promises never to leave us nor forsake us. And with that in mind, I want to hand you over to our praise and worship team. I pray that you will be blessed and have a safe week. Amen.
Good morning, family of God. Greetings in the wonderful name of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. We just want to invite you just to worship with us and to praise with us. We know that God has been so good this week and He's continuing His great things, and we just want to worship Him. So we invite you from wherever you are just to partake with us and just to sing with us and just to give God all praise, glory, and honor. Amen.
Chain, oh God, you have done great things. We dance in your freedom, awake and alive. Oh Jesus, our Savior, your name lifted high. Oh God, you have done great things. You have done great things. You have done great things. wants and requests above all things. Every hour I wake beneath me, oh God, I tasted and seen.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Greetings to you in the wonderful and precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. It's good to be back in the house of the Lord, just to come together to share God's precious word with you. And I'm very optimistic this morning that the Lord is about to break through and do something special and something supernatural. All I'm asking of you today, as you listen to my voice, to have your hearts open and sensitive to the Spirit of God. I take my reading from God's Word that's also found in the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, and we will read the first seven verses. Isaiah 61, and we'll read the first seven verses. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to console those who mourn in Zion, to give beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they may be called the trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. And they shall rebuild the old ruins. They shall raise up the former desolations. And they shall repair the ruined cities, the desolations of many generations. Strangers shall stand and feed your flocks. And your sons of the foreigner shall be your plowmen and your vine dressers. But you shall be named the priests of the Lord. They shall call you the servants of our God. You shall eat the riches of the Gentiles, and in their glory you shall boast. Verse 7, instead of your shame, you shall have double honor. Instead of confusion, they shall rejoice in their portion. Therefore, in their land, they shall possess double, everlasting joy for theirs shall be joy. Every head bowed and every eye closed. Loving God and Heavenly Father, we bow today through Jesus Christ our Lord. We are indeed so grateful for your word, and we pray your word will touch lives, Your word will touch nations, and your word will speak to us this morning, because we ask it in Jesus' name with much thanksgiving. Amen. I'd like to entitle my message this morning, Being Switched On to the Spirit of God. Just the other day, I needed to charge my cell phone. So I took the necessary steps to charge my phone. Sometime later, I returned and checked my phone if it was charged. I then realized that I forgot to switch the power button on. Many of us go through the motions of life, just plugged in, but not switched on. So even as Christians, we do many things in the natural. We can even pray. We can fast. We can attend services regularly. Give your tithes and your offering. Do feeding schemes. Even minister the word of God. But we really are not switched on. It simply means that the Spirit of the Lord is not present in whatever you are doing. So this morning I want to encourage my brothers and sisters to switch on so that the Spirit of God can help you and lead you and guide you and direct you by the power of His Holy Spirit. John's Gospel, chapter 4 and verse 24 says, God is a spirit, and those who worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. So we see that the Spirit of God touches our spirit. The Spirit of God ministers to our spirit. So if the Spirit is not active or activated, we cannot touch the presence of God. So that is why I'd like to believe that God is impressing in our hearts this morning that we know the Spirit, we feel the Spirit of God, and we begin to worship our King in spirit and in truth. The Word of God tells us in Proverbs 20 and verse 27, the spirit of a man is the lamp of the Lord, searching all the inner depths of his heart. Man's spirit is God's contact point, amen, through which he illumines man and shows him his own true nature. So, beloved, we see that as God's Spirit is in contact with man's spirit, we see that His Spirit touches us. His anointing shifts us. His anointing inspires us. And through His anointing, we can do many things, even in the kingdom. So that is why it is very important to have the Spirit of God switched on and operating in our lives every day, so that God can help us and minister unto us and guide us by His Spirit. Ezekiel 2 and verse 2 says, then the Spirit entered me when He spoke to me and set me on my feet, and I heard Him who spoke to me. What actually happened here is the Spirit of God entered Ezekiel and empowered him for the task that he was about to do. So, beloved, when you are empowered with the Spirit of God, you will be able to do any task because you are led and guided and directed by the Spirit of God. We also see in Ezekiel 3 and verse 12, the Spirit of the Lord lifted him up. In other words, when you have the Spirit of God living and guiding and directing you, the Spirit of God will lift you up. Sometimes man wants to be lifted up, but when you lift yourself up, when someone else lifts you up, you can fall. But I want to tell you, when the Lord lifts you up, He will keep you there so that you can be a blessing to the nations of this world. I like what John 6 and verse 63 says. It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak to you are spirit and they are life. So, my beloved brothers and sisters, you through the Spirit have power and authority to do many things. You can change someone's life. You can alter someone's destiny for the better, because life and power is transmitted through you, through the power and the anointing of the Holy Spirit. John 16 and verse 13 says, however, when He, the Spirit of truth, has come, He will guide you into all truth. And I'd like to believe this word guide or guidance is very, very necessary. We need the Lord to guide us. We need the Lord to guide our politicians. We need the Lord to guide our country. We need the Lord to direct and guide this world. Because if the Lord is not in our country, if the Lord is not in this world, we have a major problem. So I want to appeal to the men of God. I want to appeal to the president. I want to appeal to the nations of this world. Give God His rightful place. Let the Spirit of God take over so that there can be healing in our land. We need God to guide us. We need the power of the Holy Spirit to minister unto us. So, beloved, He will guide us into all truth. There are many false spirits, false doctrines, evil spirits that are working overtime. But when the Spirit of God comes, I'd like to believe He will dispel what is evil and wicked in the sight of God. I like what Romans 8 and verse 9 says. But you are not in the flesh, but you are in the Spirit. We are the children of the Most High God. And if indeed the Spirit of God dwells in you, now, if anyone who does not have the Spirit of Christ, he is not His. All Christians have the Holy Spirit within them. Anyone who does not have the Holy Spirit is not a Christian. Though Paul say that Christians are in the Spirit, he also warns that from time to time we live according to the flesh. Romans 8 and verse 13 says, for if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. So, beloved, we cannot live according to the worldly standards. We cannot live according to the flesh. We need to live by the Spirit. And yes, when we have the Spirit of God, the Lord will help us so that we can be victorious. Beloved, let us be switched on to the power of the mighty Holy Spirit. We see in Galatians chapter 6, verse 6 to 10, let him who is taught the word share in all good things with him who teaches. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. For he who sows in the flesh will reap corruption, but he who sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap everlasting life. And let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all, especially to those who are of the household of faith. And as a child of God, we need to always do good, irrespective if people are bad towards you. Because you have the Spirit of God, you can do good. Yes, beloved, he who sows in the flesh will reap corruption, but he who sows in the Spirit will reap everlasting life. So getting back to the word that I've read in the beginning, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. When you are switched on, the Spirit of God will be upon you. The anointing of God will be upon you. There will be a difference from you than a person that is in the world. You will always see a glow. You will always see a smile. And the anointing of God will make room. The anointing of God will make a difference. When you have the anointing, you will be able to preach the word. When you have the anointing, you'll be able to teach the word. When you have the anointing, you'll be able to bring correction. When you have the anointing, you'll be able to guide God's people accordingly. Yes, beloved, when you are switched on, when the Spirit of God is upon you, you'll be able to heal the brokenhearted. In this time of our pandemic, so many people are brokenhearted. So many people have lost their lives. Families are grieving. And that is why, when the Spirit of God is upon you, you'll be able to speak a seasoned word and you'll be able to bring healing to them. Yes, beloved, the Spirit of God is needed in so many areas. Being switched on, you'll be able to do great and mighty and powerful things. And yeah, I like what the word says, the opening of prison to those who are bound. People are bound by religion. People are bound by tradition. People are bound by the things of this world. They're bound by alcohol. They're bound by drugs. They're bound by tobacco. They're bound by fornication. And I believe the Spirit of God can set the captive free. Yes, speak a now word. Speak a seasoned word. Speak a word to them. And I believe they can receive deliverance and victory. Beloved, the word of God is true. The word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two edges of a sword. When you speak in love, God will change. God will minister and God will break through in a supernatural way. Verse 6 says, "And you shall eat the riches of the Gentiles, and in their glory you shall boast." I'd like to believe, even in this time when there is a financial constraint in the country, when our businesses are not doing well, God can open doors for you so that the riches of the Gentiles can be yours. God can bless you. God can change things. God can minister unto you. God can do supernatural miracles so that your bills are paid off, etc., etc. You've been through many tests and many trials and many troubles, but I want to tell you, through all that you have been, instead of your shame, you shall have double honor. In other words, you shall have a double blessing. God will bless you in your coming in. God will bless you in your going out. And whatever you do, my brother and my sister, you will prosper. So I want to encourage you this morning to be switched on to the power of God, to be switched on to the presence of God, to be switched on to the anointing of God. And God wants to use you in a tremendous way. Don't chase after man. Chase after the things of God. Chase after the Spirit of God. And God will surely bless you in a supernatural and in a powerful way. Thank you so much. Let us now bow for prayer. Our loving God and Heavenly Father, we need so grateful this morning that we can sense the Spirit of the living God. Because where the Spirit of God is, there is liberty and there is freedom. And today, Lord, I'm standing on behalf of your dear children, and I'm trusting you for unusual miracles and unusual breakthroughs. We pray, Lord, from this day onwards, we will not live in the flesh, but we will live in the Spirit. We will seek the things of God, because your word says, for those who serve you, for those who worship you, needs to worship you in spirit and in truth. I pray today we will not go in the motions of just being plugged in, but we will be switched on to the things of God, so that you can use us in a tremendous way. We pray, Lord, this morning for unusual miracles to take place. Even by the listening of your word, people will be tuned in to the Spirit of God. Signs, wonders, and miracles will break through, and you'll meet with them even in a supernatural and in a powerful way. We come against the tempter, we come against the devourer, and we cancel him in Jesus' mighty name. Especially this coronavirus, we come against it. And when so many of our very own people are affected, we rebuke it in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we command God's people to be healed, God's people to be delivered, God's people to be set free in a supernatural way. I pray this morning that every need will be met, oh God, in a supernatural way. Every business to flourish through the power of the Holy Spirit. Bless your people and give them a supernatural and divine protection, so that your name will be glorified. Bless all our students, anoint them, strengthen them, give them wisdom, so that the Spirit of God and the Spirit of excellence can be upon them. Bless all our women. Lord, take them into a new level. Draw them close unto thee, and may they experience your grace and your power and your love in a supernatural way. So Lord, we commit this entire week unto thee, and we pray that you'd help us, lead and guide and direct us by your Holy Spirit, because we ask it in Jesus' name with much thanksgiving. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. God bless every one of you.